Friends, my name is Abhishek Pareek. I am CEO of Atal Incubation Center, Banasthali Vidyapeeth. Atal Incubation Center at Banasthali is supported by Atal Innovation Mission, Niti Aayog, a flagship initiative of Government of India to transform India through innovation and entrepreneurship. AIC at Banasthali is one of its kind incubation center in India solely focusing on women-led startups. We currently have 27 women startups incubated with us under incubation and accelerator program. We have a special focus on social entrepreneurship, and our startups come from different parts of the country. I also head eCell, entrepreneurship cell at Banasthali, which is supported by India's largest bank, State Bank of India. It is again a unique initiative of India's largest bank to collaborate with the world's largest residential university for women to promote entrepreneurship as a culture in women. The eCell has benefited more than 5,000 women by orienting them on entrepreneurship. The eCell also helps students in facilitating their ideas, providing sector-specific mentoring, giving them exposure on various aspects of entrepreneurship, and motivating them to take entrepreneurial plunge. Friends, today we would like to talk about promoting the spirit of entrepreneurship and startups in students. I would like to divide my discussion in 5 W's, that is who, what, where, when, why of entrepreneurship. Starting with the first W, which is who, we are talking about the students who are being told from ages that they have to perform well and have to go for best of the companies for placements. The student starts preparation for best colleges early in life and then work on their skills for best of the companies. But seldom are they told to start their ventures. I reckon when I was in college, no one used to talk about starting their own enterprises other than the people who have family businesses background. Why suddenly everyone has started talking about startups? That too from students. The answer is, we have realized that India has more than 50% of its population below the age of 25 and more than 65% below the age of 35. It is expected that in 2020, the average age of an Indian will be 29 years, compared to 37 for China and 48 for Japan. While on the other hand, due to technological advancements, new jobs are drying up. For a young nation like India, creating jobs is very important, and there is no better way than to motivate youth to start their own ventures and become job creators instead of job seekers. The second aspect of who is the faculty or college university administration who have to motivate young minds to think out of the box and choose entrepreneurship as a career option. This is a tremendous responsibility for us, as we have to be very careful in choosing the right student for the right job. What I essentially mean is that we do not have to blindly push students for becoming an entrepreneur. We have to carefully see bright spots and motivate them so as to avoid student failures later on. Every student will not become entrepreneur, but then making them enterprising is what we have to focus on. If the job of school is to prepare students for college and career, then it is also essential for us as educators to teach entrepreneurship. Now that does not mean every student has to start a business. The Network for Teaching Entrepreneurship, NFTE, notes that an extensive body of literature suggests entrepreneurial skills such as creative problem solving, collaboration are important for academic success. In other words, even for students who never want to launch a startup, entrepreneurial education is beneficial. When students hone their critical thinking and problem solving skills, they prepare for college, career, and for the 21st century success. At this stage, it is very critical to understand the difference between an entrepreneur, entrepreneurship, and enterprising students. Entrepreneur is an individual who founds and runs a small business and assumes all the risk and reward of the venture. Entrepreneurship is an activity or process of setting up a business or businesses, taking on financial risk in the hope of profit. Enterprising means having or showing initiative and resourcefulness. Enterprising consists of two things. The first is creativity. You need creativity to see what's out there and to shape it to your advantage. You need creativity to look at the world a little differently. You need creativity to take a different approach and to be different. The second requirement is the courage to be creative. You need courage to see things differently. Courage to go against the crowd. Courage to take a different approach. Courage to stand alone if you have to. Courage to choose activity over inactivity. And that's the most important task for us as educators. we have to make students ready to think out of the box, improve their creative thinking abilities, improve their ability to look at the world differently, and we have to develop courage in them to go against the crowd, courage to take a different approach, courage to stand out of the crowd, courage to choose activity over inactivity. This brings me to my second W, which is what. So entrepreneurship is the answer to above. Entrepreneurship is an activity that can not only enhance student success academically, but strengthen confidence, instill qualities and skills conducive to success upon graduation. Starting young is good. You can either learn through failing or you can learn by being successful. Student entrepreneurs gain hands-on experience with their education, grow their personal networks, and have no choice but to become more diligent with their study time. In a world that is increasingly interdisciplinary, solutions to seemingly intractable problems will be solved by bringing together business, government, and social issues. Students with the ability to think across disciplines and sectors prepare themselves for long-term success. As I mentioned above, we don't have to create startups. We have to create good entrepreneurs or enterprising students with creative thinking abilities and courage to stand out. For us as teachers, we have to turn class discussions into positive debates, introduce project-based learning tools like solving real-world problems by seeking solutions from students, making them think through the problem and finding the right solution fits, and lastly, developing the right skill sets for students to succeed in entrepreneurial world. My third W is where. University education is increasingly becoming more diverse with a greater emphasis on the whole experience, not just the actual academics. Entrepreneurship education is becoming more prominent with many students seeking out extracurricular activities and taking on additional classes in order to learn more about how to succeed in a business. Collaboration and multidisciplinary working is becoming more the norm, increasing the average student's exposure to entrepreneurial activities and thinking. I believe university is the best time to start on your idea or solution, as it gives good visibility on things. Entrepreneurship can be quite stressful, but starting at university allows a student to gain the necessary life skills and confidence to make it in the real world by gaining hands-on experience, entrepreneurial tutors and lecturers, and by taking advantage of free resources from the university. College eSales allows students to meet like-minded people, creating an atmosphere of creativity and collaborative learning. Entrepreneurship allows students to learn more than just their chosen field of study and creates an interdisciplinary environment to work and develop in. The networks and friendships which develop help students to become better connected once they leave the university and help prepare them for long-term success. In order to implement this seamlessly, the basic requirement is to form a student-run e-cell, an entrepreneurship cell, which can conduct various creative activities, encourage students from different streams to come together and brainstorm on solutions, bringing out cross-sector solutions and in turn motivating students to think creatively. The e-cell has to be a vibrant place full of creative activities, encouraging students to participate and get benefit out of it, with a long-term vision to promote entrepreneurship as a culture and career option. The challenge here is student attrition due to courses, but we have to figure out a right way for continuous functioning of e-cell. A faculty mentor can be assigned specially for the purpose of maintaining liveliness and continuity of the e-cell. The e-cell can conduct various activities like bringing real-time entrepreneurs for motivating the students, providing opportunities for students to sell handmade products in the campus, industrial visits to startups, rural immersion programs, conducting business plan competitions, workshops on marketing, business model, financial model, idea carnivals, hackathons, product innovation competitions, etc. The objective of above is to drive creative thinking abilities of the students, understanding the process of idea generation, making them find solutions for pressing problems, working on the solutions, helping them in implementation of idea, facilitating the good ideas to flourish, and so on. One thing I would like to mention here, which I feel is very important, is exposing the students to social issues, as most of the ideas and their solutions need attention of and involvement of socially motivated youth. Coming on to the fourth W, which is when, I feel the seed of entrepreneurship has to be sown as early as possible. Our experience says you have to catch them young. Ideally, the thought of creative thinking and finding solutions to real world issues should start in school education only. If not there, then in first year of UGPG programs, so to expose students. The student moves ahead in education, they get preoccupied with lot of competition, family expectations, comparison with peers and launching their career, somehow leaving behind their ability to see problems of the world. In fact, I have two answers for when. The first one is to start early, as I talked about above. This is for those who are clear with their directions of life, the ones having a defined idea solution and have made up their mind to take entrepreneurial plans. Ideally, as faculties, we have to motivate this set of students, and if required, we can also give them required mentoring through faculty industry mentors to prepare them beforehand. If required, we can also waive some assignments or transfer credits against the work towards their startup. The second are the students who are not sure of taking that plunge. For them, it is advisable to work in that particular area for some years, and then basis their judgment, they can take their decision to start up. The point I'm trying to drive is that as well wishers of students, our job is to identify the right students and motivate them for the right path accordingly. Just pushing them to become entrepreneurs and starting their ventures will not work. The last W is about why, which has the highest relevance. This why has to be answered to come out with a clear objective. As I have shared above on the demographic status of Indian youth, which is one of the major reasons we have to look at alternative career opportunities for the youth, along with advancements in technology, which is eating up traditional jobs. But I would like to discuss this why here more towards students and educators' perspective. I feel the best time for a student to explore the field of entrepreneurship is when they are studying. They do not have anything to lose at that time. If during their course they find this fit, they can go ahead for launching their startups. If somehow they fail, they can go for placement. What is more important for the students is the process of becoming an entrepreneur, the creative thinking approach, out-of-the-box solution seeker, which will help them throughout their lives. Even companies these days are looking for candidates with entrepreneurial bent of mind, having capability to bring innovation at the workplace and to the old processes. As educators, we have to see what are we bringing at the table for students to become entrepreneurs. Doing it just because the world is talking about startups is not the right approach. We have to think with a long-term perspective, which has to be implemented through long-term planning. As they say, we have to bring the culture of entrepreneurship in air. The idea should be to give opportunity to each and every child to think through their dreams, explore their ideas, let them explore solutions to the pressing problems of the world, and make them future ready. I would also like to mention about incubation centers and academic institutions coming up these days. There is a difference between an ECEL and an incubation center. As I mentioned earlier, ECEL typically orients and motivates students on entrepreneurship, helps students with the process of idea generation, and make them explore business opportunity in their ideas. While an incubation center is a step further to ECEL, incubation center provides wings to ideas, helps create a viable business model around that idea, helps in proof of concept, helps in developing market validation for the product or service, helps in go-to-market strategies, helps in commercialization of product or service, provides sector-specific mentoring, provides corporate or government connects, and finally helping the startup idea to get funding. In a nutshell, incubation centers give wings for ideas to fly. Incubation centers typically focuses on local area synergies to help startups and enterprises in that geography. There are a lot of government schemes through which institutions can get funding for setting up academic incubation centers. There are schemes available at central government and state government both, like Atal Innovation Mission, Department of Science and Technology, Technology Development Board, Technology Business Incubators, Ministry of MSME, then there are schemes available at the state level too. These days, even corporates are setting up incubation centers under their CSR initiatives. both state and central governments have a special focus for creating entrepreneurs for the country who have capacity to bring change and solve social issues. Academic incubators are not for profit but have a huge task of synergizing the local ecosystem like technology, design and management. The institution has to see how their strengths can be synergized to provide a platform for students of various departments to come together to churn out innovative technologies which have a potential to become big businesses. Incubation centers can become platform for ideas to convert into a business model. It is important for all faculties to be aligned with the focus on entrepreneurship so that every faculty can equally motivate and provide right direction to the students. One more thing I would like to stress upon is social entrepreneurship, which has much relevance for countries like India. There is huge opportunity for students to work upon solutions to local problems, solutions to social issues, solutions which can help millions of poor or needy population. Only thing which they have to focus on is that solutions to these social issues can be wrapped around with technology for making them scalable, cost-effective, and helps in faster implementation. The challenge here for the institutions is how to motivate a young student to start a venture. But they have to work hard to help and nurture some good startups which can become inspiration for others to follow. Ideally, the e-cell should feed into incubation center, and the success of startups in incubation center should motivate students for joining e-cell. It might take some time to create that culture for students to take bold steps, but once the institution has some student success stories, it will be big motivation for others to follow. As a country, we need all sorts of manpower at all levels. Everyone cannot become an entrepreneur. Likewise, everyone should not be pushed to become job seekers. We need to maintain the right balance by empowering youth, give wings to their ideas, work on social issues, become job creators to help transforming India. Before we end, I would like to show you a brief video about AIC Banasthali.
Although more women are embracing entrepreneurship, but they face challenges that are typically not shared by their male counterparts. Hence, there is a need of incubation center that is empathetic to the requirements of women entrepreneurs. Atal Incubation Center Banasthali Vidyapeeth focuses solely on women-led startups. We are not just nurturing their ideas, but also the entrepreneur to strengthen the ecosystem across the country. With the support of Atal Innovation Mission, we have started in December 27 with the announcement of two programs, V-Sprint, a 6-month acceleration program with rigorous mentoring support and capital support, and Womenpreneur, a 11-month incubation program. The programs are a mix of social and commercial startups. Currently, we have 27 incubatees with us. AIC Banasthali Vidyapeeth offers access to world-class laboratories, modern equipment, state-of-the-art infrastructure, a huge mentor and network support, and funding opportunities to the women-led startups. Atal Innovation Mission, under the leadership of Honorable Prime Minister, has been immensely supportive towards our vision of empowering women through entrepreneurship. AIM has helped us in nurturing the ideas of women, creating a conducive environment, a women-friendly culture, and also developing women entrepreneurial network. We once again thank Team Atal Innovation Mission for enabling the vibrant entrepreneurial ecosystem across India.